Ho, ho, ho. Anyway, welcome to the Full Circle Music Show, the why of the music biz. And this is our special Christmas episode.
Yes.
Man, we just had a awesome time last night at our company Christmas party.
Yeah, it was crazy. It was a great night of, you know, almost 100 people walking through the house, hanging out with us, visiting the studio, catching up on old times and looking forward to new times.
You're alive?
I am alive. Made it out of here. We had luxurious cars actually shuttling people around, so I felt very safe.
We did.
Very secure.
We did, and the feedback was great. If you guys want to see some pictures for that, we're going to be posting them on our socials, yep. Instagram,
yep.
At official FC Music.
The food was so great, too. I actually had more of it today. That's how good it was.
The food was incredible, and you can also see a picture of that on our socials as well. I think you should check that out.
You should definitely check it out.
Man, it's been an incredible year. Some of the highlights, we've had four unbelievable events this year on the Full Circle Music Academy side.
Yep.
Some songwriting retreats. We had a production retreat, and we had a
full-on boot camp.
Boot camp, we did.
Start the year out.
And we're gearing up for four more next year.
Yep.
But we're going to take a little break from the business side and do a little Christmas special for you this week.
Yeah, a little something. We figured, you know, everyone's heading home, going to spend some time with the family, so we thought we'd just throw together something fun for you guys to digest while either you're in the car, on the plane, waiting in line at the airport. Hopefully you're not in Atlanta and the power doesn't go out on you again, but I heard Chick-fil-A made like 5,000 sandwiches for those people.
I love Chick-fil-A.
Yeah, me too. And they opened on a Sunday to do it. How crazy is that?
And one thing we learned, was it Chick-fil-A? Was it about the author that told us about this?
Oh, yeah, the free food.
Free food hack. In case you missed that podcast, you should definitely go back and listen to it. That was the
Chick-fil-A
episode.
Chick-fil-A and Chipotle.
Chick-fil-A and Chipotle. That was the episode, if you search back through our archives, hacks for touring indie bands, and that was with about the author. And what was that hack?
That
just
hack is,
in case people missed it,
that Chick-fil-A and Chipotle both have budgets to support indie artists or artists in general. So if you go in, I think you have to call when you're heading there and let them know that you're a touring band or a musician or artist of some kind. And I believe if you bring them a CD or a piece of merch, they will actually give you free food.
Does the piece of merch have to be over a certain dollar amount?
I'm hoping not, because I have stickers from my old band that I'm looking to cash.
That's what I was going to say.
On my way home.
I have drumsticks back from my touring days. Wonder if they would do it for me.
Dude, I don't see why not.
Yeah. Anyway, there'll be a lot of drumming in the Franklin Chick-fil-A kitchen, so watch out. But I love this episode. This was just something fun. We interviewed several friends of ours just about several questions related to their favorite Christmas memories.
Yeah.
And that sounds a little vague, but I promise some of them are absolutely worth listening to. Even if you haven't heard of these people, some of them I'm sure you have. We've got Bart Millard from the band MercyMe.
Yep.
We've got Seth Morrison from the band Skillet, as well as Jen Ledger.
Yeah, Jen Ledger also from
the band Skillet.
The rock and roll band Skillet. Yeah, we've got all sorts of people in this thing. A couple of the kids from I Am They, who we just finished working with. I think
Matt,
we have Hammitt. Abby.
Yep, got everybody. So stick around to the end. This is a really fun one. And yes, again, just follow us on social media at official FC Music. We would love for you tweet us, you know, whatever your favorite Christmas presents are. I'd love to see that.
Yep, absolutely.
We were just joking in the car on the way back to the studio that pretty much all of X's wish list is pretty nerdy this year.
Yeah, it's all computer related stuff. I am the most unfun person at Christmas this year. It's like, ooh, this dock would be nice for my laptop. Oh, this Bluetooth keyboard would be awesome. It also has hotkeys written on top of it.
So, ladies and gentlemen, be looking for a picture on our socials. I'm holding you to this. Please post a picture of you with all of your Christmas presents.
I will show you guys what I end up with, and hopefully there'll be a pocket protector. I think half of what I asked for comes with one included from Amazon.
We are a media company, so we're nerds. So
exactly.
If you're listening to this, send us anything Thunderbolt, USB, Bluetooth related.
Yep.
And
we'll accept anything.
We'll be happy. Anyway, let's jump into the interview. Not the interview, the episode, the Christmas special episode. Hey, this is Seth Mosley with Full Circle Music, and my favorite Christmas story is probably similar to a lot of you. When I was a kid, I used to wake up, I could hardly sleep, you know, the night before Christmas, and so I'd wake up at like 3 in the morning, run downstairs, see if Santa had left presents and, you know, filled the stockings. And of course he did. Santa liked to come to our house around midnight. And there was one Christmas that we were living in Ohio, a little town called Circleville, Ohio, where I grew up. And I went downstairs. I just could not sleep. And I was probably 8 or 9 years old. Went downstairs at 3 a.m. and I got freaked out because I saw the silhouette of somebody standing in the window. And I was like, oh crap, is my dad like, or Santa there standing guard? I think by the time I was 8, I probably didn't believe in Santa. But I was like, is my dad there standing guard so I don't go down and open the presents? And so I freaked out and ran back into the room. And then the next morning I came down at like 6 when we were finally allowed to get up. I realized it was a life-size cutout of Michael Jordan standing in the window. And that was one of my Christmas presents. And I felt kind of dumb, but it was an awesome present. And that stayed in my room until I was probably at least 12.
Hey, this is John McConnell from the band I Am They. And my favorite Christmas movie has to be Die Hard. Bruce Willis does an amazing job in the movie, and it just always brings me back to when I was a kid, just sitting around the fireplace watching a movie at my grandma's place. And yeah.
This is Mike Lee, and my favorite Christmas song is really a collection of songs, really anything by Elvis Presley. Growing up, my dad was a big Elvis fan, and so I was a big Elvis fan. And so, man, just a throwback, Blue Christmas.
I'll have a blue Christmas without you.
That's it, Elvis, yeah.
Hey, this is Stacey Wilbur, and my favorite Christmas movie is Elf. I love this movie and watch it every year, probably at least 20 or 30 times before Christmas comes, because it makes me laugh, it brings the Christmas spirit, and I pretty much know every single word of the movie.
Hey, this is Matt from I Am They, and man, my favorite Christmas food, besides eggnog — eggnog doesn't count, it should count, but if it wasn't eggnog, it's got to be those Danish butter cookies. We all know what I'm talking about. They only come around Christmas time of the year. You open that can up, and you know what? There's so many good things to choose from, but I go straight for the pretzel wrap Danish butter cookie with the little sprinkles on top. Good heavens. The Lord has blessed it. I mean, glory to God for those things.
Hey everyone, I'm Ben Calhoun from Citizen Way, and my favorite Christmas story is from when we were kids. We used to make our own ornaments, and my brother, his name is Josh, he used to spell his name wrong, and he would put an L instead of a J, and so it spelled Losh. And to this day in my phone, his name is Losh.
Hey, what's up, guys? This is Seth from the band Skillet, and my favorite Christmas movie, and has been for as long as I can remember, is Home Alone. It just brings back a great sense of nostalgia from my childhood, and I used to watch that movie over and over, and then I would rewind and watch the trap scenes multiple times, where Kevin sets up the traps and basically just inflicts horrible pain up on Marv and Harry, the robbers that are trying to get him. I used to think it was hilarious. I still think it's hilarious. And that's kind of like the movie for my wife and I that will officially like kick off the Christmas season. The day after Thanksgiving is when it's official that we can watch it. My wife will finally let us watch it. And to this day, that is still one of my favorite Christmas movies.
Hey, this is Logan Crockett, VP of Marketing for Full Circle Music. My favorite Christmas song, or the one that probably means the most to me, is Breath of Heaven by Amy Grant. When I was younger, we had a group at my church called the E-Team. I went to a church in Dayton, Ohio called Fairhaven, and they had this group for 5th and 6th graders. They called it the E-Team, and it was this basically like a performing group. So they did skits and puppets and mimes and clowns and dance and all sorts of stuff. And I remember just growing up, the E-Team would perform for everyone 1st grade through 6th grade. And pretty much my entire time, 1st grade all the way through 6th grade, every single Christmas that came around, the dance team, so just, you know, 5th and 6th graders rehearsing and dancing to a certain song, every Christmas they would always do one to Breath of Heaven by Amy Grant. And just because of that, like at just such a young age, I kind of really fell in love with that song and the way that it was presented. Just the way that little performing group did it was just really, really cool and meaningful. And so, yeah, ever since then, I've just, every time I hear that song, that's definitely the memory that sticks out in my head.
Hey, this is Michael Gomez, and my favorite Christmas story is that in the Dominican Republic, where I'm from, first of all, it's not Santa Claus that brings the gifts because apparently it's too hot in the Dominican. So it's the three wise men. They come in January 6th and they bring the gifts. And so instead of having all the presents and all those things on the 25th, what we have is just a family dinner. And it's just really, really chill, and it's really more about family than the presents. And then on the 6th, only the kids get presents. But growing up in Dominican, my mom used to have me put under the tree three things. And it was three cigarettes, separate cigarettes. I know, it's funny. And three little shot glasses with rum and grass. And apparently, the three wise men traveled from afar and they were thirsty, so they wanted some rum and they wanted to smoke a cigarette. I don't know why. And the camels wanted some grass. And that's kind of tradition out there, I guess.
Hey, this is Abby from the band I Am They. And my favorite song to hear at Christmas is Happy Christmas, War is Over by John Lennon and Yoko Ono. And I love it because of that bridge that just says, it's the Harlem Children's Choir singing, "War is over if you want it, war is over now." And I think it's a really timeless message. It was written for to promote the end of war and to promote peace in the Vietnam era. But I think every year at Christmas, we find ourselves with conflict continuing to happen around us. And that's why I love to hear that song every Christmas, because war can be over if we want it. That's something that we can pursue and attain. And Christmas is a great time to think about that.
Hey, what's up? This is Matt Hammitt. And my favorite story about Christmas for me was when my parents got me all these gifts. I opened them all, and I was still foolishly, as a child, disappointed because there's one thing that I didn't get until they said, "Oh, wait, I think there's one more hiding behind the couch." And sure enough, there it was, the guitar that I've been waiting for. My very first guitar on that Christmas. Best Christmas memory for me.
What up? This is Trev from TFK. My favorite Christmas movie, hands down, is Christmas Vacation. Just like, no contenders. My parents are big It's a Wonderful Life fans, and I respect that.
Hey guys, this is Jericho, and I know a lot of you are expecting me to pick a favorite movie, but my favorite Christmas song is Carol of the Bells. It doesn't matter what version is out there. I've heard so many of them, and that's the thing. I love every single one. It doesn't matter if it's a choir singing it, the classical versions with the symphony, or August Burns Red. Every single one that I've heard, I just love, and it gets me in the mood, And that's the other thing. I can actually listen to it year-round. So, hands down, favorite Christmas song, Carol of the Bells.
Hi, this is Jen from Skillet, and my favorite Christmas food has to be... I don't know if you have this in America, but in England we have a thing called cauliflower cheese, which is basically, you know, cooked cauliflower in a delicious, creamy, melted cheese sauce. And the thing that's awesome about it is when it's put on your plate, it kind of meshes with your other food, and it's like cheese sauce galore. So I'm a huge fan of it. I can never have enough of it. And that would be my favorite Christmas part of the meal.
Hey everybody, my name is Tim Timmons. It's a real name, it's not a joke. I think one of my favorite Christmas memories as a kid was when I got a keyboard. I mean, I'd been wanting a Kawai keyboard, and I mean, it had like 200 sounds on it, like aw and ooh and some cool things like that. So I remember wanting something so bad. I remember that. That was a pretty great Christmas memory.
Hey, my name is X, and I wanted to tell you guys my favorite Christmas movie. It's a classic that some of you may know, some of you might not know, and if you do not know it, you must go and watch it, because it's epic. Little film called The Ref, with my favorite comedian in the world, Mr. Dennis Leary, also starring Judy Davis and Mr. Kevin Spacey. A classic film. It honestly has nothing to do with Christmas, other than the fact that it takes place over Christmas, but for some reason, growing up, one of my best friends when I was a teenager, his name's Chris Vasquez, he and I saw this movie with our parents, and we just made it a habit every year at Christmas time. Even when we were in college, we'd come back home from college, we'd get together, we'd watch this movie. It's awesome. It's about a cat burglar who breaks into a guy's house, and then he tries to blend in by hiding with a family while the police are looking for him. It's absolutely hilarious. I would highly recommend it. But yeah, that is my favorite Christmas movie, The Ref.
Hey, this is Colton Dixon, and my favorite Christmas food is my mama's sweet potato casserole. What's great is we get it for Thanksgiving and Christmas, so we double up.
My name is Bart Millard, the lead singer of the band MercyMe. My favorite Christmas memory would be, I have an older brother, and whenever Santa would come, Santa was smart enough to put his toys in one corner of the room and my toys in the other on Christmas morning. And I don't remember how old I was young, but I wanted a BB gun and he wanted a jam box. Somehow Santa got it wrong, and I had a jam box in my chair, and he had a BB gun, but being a little brother, I wanted anything my brother wanted, and so I was happy with the jam box. He was not happy with the BB gun, so he switched it, and a very big fight ensued. My brother's 5 years older than me, and at some point, I hit him in the back of the head, breaking the stock of the BB gun over his head. Thought I killed him. He fell to the ground, and actually pretended to be unconscious to make sure that I got the most severe beating of my life. And then miraculously woke up, and then he didn't want the BB gun because the handle was broken. And so I got a stupid broken BB gun. And then we had a cooked Christmas goose, and everything was fine.
Hi, this is Seth Mosley.
And this is X O'Connor.
Merry Christmas, and thank you for listening to the Full Circle Music Show, The Why of the Music Biz. In just one month, we're going to be having an absolutely huge announcement about this podcast.
Yeah, I believe it coincides with our 100th episode, if I'm not mistaken.
Holy cow, we're coming up on episode 100.
Yeah, I think we're like 5 weeks away from it, five episodes away from 100.
That is insane. Yeah. So stick around. You do not want to miss what's coming up. Some massive changes, good changes. People out there don't like change, but I promise... Yeah. The kids are going to enjoy this change.
Yeah, absolutely. We've got some surprises in store, some big guests coming up. We've got a lot of the year mapped out, and we are very excited with what's to come. You guys are going to love it.
You can almost consider the first 100 episodes, the beta test.
Yep. We were just warming up. We got some stretching done.
It's
time for the race.
It's time for the actual thing. But seriously, we have worked out a lot of, you know, what works, what doesn't, and just have some power-packed interviews coming up. We're really, really trying to drill down. Ultimately, we know the reason why you guys listen to this podcast is because you want to learn something. You want a takeaway, a tangible takeaway every episode. So we want to leave you with that. We don't want it to just be about somebody's story and have nothing applicable to your musical journey.
Yep.
So it's going to transition a little bit in format, but it's going to be so good.
Yeah, we've been working on it, and we're super excited about it. Yeah. I know I'm excited just from the bits that we've already played around with. It's going to be great.
And in case people haven't already caught up on this, all of these episodes are on YouTube now.
They are. Yes, we've been working on our video content.
We're
trying to keep up with the kids.
Yeah, so the video is just getting better and better. Most of these interviews are, from here forward, going to be in video format. Mostly live here at our studio, so you can get a little glimpse inside Full Circle Music.
A little peek behind the curtain.
So, yeah, subscribe over there. That's just like all the socials, at Official FC Music.
Yeah. Also, Merry Christmas to all of you. I know you guys are going to be traveling, being safe. Hopefully you enjoyed this episode. Hopefully it brought you a little relief from any stresses that come during the holiday times. So, you know, Merry Christmas to y'all. Thanks for joining us. You know, it's been a great year. We've, like Seth just said, we've got a lot of big stuff coming in the new year. We are so excited to bring it to you guys. It's going to be a lot of fun. Man, I'm getting chills just thinking about it.
We'll see you next week.